I would like us to take a very, very close look as to why, for a very long time, both within the shores of this country and, of course, outside Nigeria, why they continue to say that youths are the leaders of tomorrow. And I'll give you three different reasons. One is the issue of maturity. The elderly ones believe that the youth are not mature enough to take certain decisions or to take charge. Even when you are, they believe you are too small. And that is why even in your homes, sometimes they tell you that you are too young to eat certain parts of animal or meat. They will come and say, maybe when they cry, you have grown up from maybe a polar village, and then the he-goat is slaughtered. And by the time you are 22, trying to approach it, and they say, please take your time, know that the scrotum is not for small children. In which case, it's assumed that you are not mature enough to eat that part of the meat. And that issue of maturity is also the reason why, when companies want to advertise for jobs, they want to hire, they say 10 years experience is needed. How old would you be to have acquired 10 years experience? Particularly in a country where even the job is not available. They believe that at 10 years you must have acquired so many knowledge, you would have grown and having to be able to acquire that maturity to deal with a whole lot of issues. Instead of them thinking of even if it's 1 year experience, that you also should be able to either come in and go with the job, but that certainly you may also have some innate characteristics. And so they believe that you belong to the future where you may have acquired 10 years for you to get the job. Secondly, is the issue of sensibility. It is believed that as a youth, you may not be sensible enough to understand a whole lot of issues. And that you lack the knowledge or the wherewithal in terms of your mental alertness to deal with a whole lot of complex issues. And as such, when they want to talk about those who should take decisions or those who should leave, they say, no, you belong to tomorrow and you belong to the future. And that makes them now take you away from taking decisions of today. And then lastly of the three issues is the issue of sensitivity. Some persons may look at sensitivity from the point of being clingy. That's not what I mean. Sensitivity has to be able to empathize and put other persons in your own shoe and let them understand what you feel and possibly understand what they feel and be able to look at them and put yourself in their shoe so that when you are taking a decision, you are able to take into cognizance the effect of that decision on the person that is going to be at the receiving end of whatever outcome your decision will be. For these three reasons, many believe that leaders of tomorrow are the youth, in which case you are not mature enough, you are not sensible enough, and you are not sensitive enough to the realities of the moment to be able to take charge of the moment. And now the issue is, what do we do as youths if indeed we must be able to take charge and perform? But don't also forget that even in the midst of this age, there are those who have also been able to do exploits, which is what the proponents of the youth and leaders of tomorrow fail to realize. There are individuals even at the age of 10, 15, have been able to do something remarkable. But unfortunately, even when that happens, we will say he is that there's a name for it, but the person is just maybe one out of many, and you say he's in his kid, even when he or she may have done something that is not out of the ordinary. But because we underestimate the youth, we are always amazed when they do things that ordinarily even we as adults cannot do. Now, having talked about the issue of sensitivity and the issue of maturity, then who are the leaders that we need today? The leaders that we need to belong largely to the youth. And the reason is because at that point, they have the energy to even experiment what does not exist. Discovery is when you are able to tread on paths that have not been followed before. So if you say it's about experience, those who discover the good things that we use today, they were not following experience to discover them. They took risks and they're able to discover that there's something new that can add value to humanity. Those who built the vehicle that we drive on today, they did not build it out of experience. They built it by trying and by taking risks. So that forms the issue of you having to be very, very mature before you can take leadership. I do recall that Sultan Mohammed III at the age of 22, led his army to overcome Constantinople. If you also go through the Bible, and indeed a good number of literary studies, you would have discovered that many a time you see much more younger persons taking decisions and liberating their people. Because they are able to understand that you need to dare. Because when you become too scared to jump, you end up not jumping at all. Even if they say jumping without looking, you may jump into the pit. But sometimes you need to also take a very good step, because that jumping may make a whole lot of difference. As a youth, if indeed you are interested in taking charge of today, which is you want to fast forward and bring back that future and make it to happen today, there are certain challenges that have made it not to happen. One I have mentioned earlier, which is the issue of unemployment. You don't have jobs, you don't have those things that will empower you, and because you don't have jobs, you don't even have the resources to be able to, even if you have a research you want to go into, you want to come into politics, you want to do a whole lot of stuff, you're not able to do it because you are unemployed, and by being unemployed, if you are, even when something happens, as they say in my place, that man who doesn't go out in the public, who doesn't go to work, when even a little farm is chicken, is missing in the community, they usually just go to him, say, after all, this man didn't go somewhere today. He may have been the one who took the chicken, even when you are inside your room. So you discover that because people are unemployed, it is believed that those who are stealing, those who are criminals, those who have done all the worst things, are those who are not employed. But they fail to realize that a man who just passed 60 years to run concurrently for 8 years was not unemployed when he took over 2 billion naira from our coffers. And then, there's something the president said one time, and a number of persons got angry when he said Nigerian youth are this. Yes, that was too generalized in nature, and possibly because it was coming from a man that was expected to provide a solution. But the fact is that there seems to be a whole lot of laziness amongst our youth. That is not to say that elders are not also lazy. Laziness in the sense that you want to just get it today without working for it today. If you want to get it today, there are efforts you must put in. You shouldn't just be mounting it. No, we want to take over. How are you going to take over? You must prepare yourself to take over. So laziness has also been identified as a major challenge why you have not been able to take charge of today. And yes, you are also looking at tomorrow. The social media, my very good friend and brother, when he was talking about TikTok a while ago, Oguz Baba, told you the many advantages of the social media. But there are also a lot of disadvantages that make youth not to be able to use the social media, to be able to engage and make a difference. Rather, the social media even retards the ability to think. A number of our youth go into the social media to look at those things that are just funny without learning anything from the phone. And as such, even the time they didn't either read or do some important or engage in discussion, they just go into the social media, they laugh away, they watch from one end. Skips to the other without learning a single thing. So we must also be able to watch it and use the social media positively. If we must overcome that challenge of not belonging to the future but belonging to today. There is also this issue of drug abuse and alcohol. I know most of you can relate very well to that. That even as youths, by the time you engage in drug abuse, you are taking a good lot of alcohol. And by the end they say, now we did here. Now where you did? If you continue to do that and you say some of my friends, even when they take it, they say, I was wrong. It nothing that happened. Let me tell you, many things are happening. Even when we are saying nothing that happened. And so you don't need to allow that alcohol or the drug to drive you. That brings us back to the issue of sensibility. If you are an alcohol addict, how can you be sensible to take charge of your today while not waiting for tomorrow to come? Of course, I mentioned the issue of poverty. I don't also want to exclude those of us in authority who oftentimes have subjected the youth to bad governance and not able to provide the needed opportunities for the youth to explore their God-given potentials and for them to make a difference. So you need to also try as much as possible to overcome that. There are lack of funds that I've talked about earlier, and then of course the issue of very poor state of education. And I want to say something that most of you may not be happy about, and that is the issue of free education. Why do we continue to talk about free education when at the end of the day, that education that you say is free is not entirely free, because what people are actually acquiring is not education but ignorance? You say free education every day, but if I take statistics of those of us who are there, who are parents, whose children are in public school, you will discover that the percentage will be less than 10. Look at the performance of these young chaps a while ago. That is not a product of the public school. Go and ask them how much their parents are paying for them to be in those schools that are functional. And you want government to give free education. Government does not even have the resources to really give you that free education because the funds are not there. Somebody will give birth to a child, you don't throw the child into the school. In short, they don't pay. You have parents' association that pays some contribution. While the government can begin to pay the salaries of the teachers, the parents are able to provide chairs and some other repairs. For these days, easily somebody give birth to a child, he doesn't want to care about something. And you just believe that government will do everything. At the end of the day, government is not able to do everything like this. And that accounts for what the reason why you have very poor education and our people, the public schools are not doing as much as they should because education requires a whole lot of funding. All those are some of the challenges. Why becoming the leader of today is a challenge, it's a mirror. But let's now look at how we can now overcome and indeed take charge of today. You must, as a youth, have a vision. If you do not have a destination of where you want to go to, you know what? Every bus stop will look as if it's your destination. So in which case, if you are going to ShopRite, by the time you go to Gaps, you don't need to begin to guess, is this ShopRite? In which case you have to slow down to begin to think whether you have to enter. Because you already know that your destination is ShopRite, and ShopRite is located in at the interval. So when you get to Mary and Babangida Junction and you see a very big shop like the Gaps supermarket, you don't have to tell them at least stop first, let me check. Because that time when you are stopping to check, you are wasting your time, you are wasting your resources, and you may end up not being able to get to shop right because there will be some traffic that will stop you. What you need to do is to be able to know where am I headed. That vision is very important. Don't become jack of all trades, because most often you are likely going to become master of none. So once you have that vision of where you want to be, you will indeed be in a position to take charge of your today and not wait for your tomorrow. And when you also desire to take charge of your tomorrow, today, you are in the midst of people, which means you belong to society. And if you belong to a society, what makes society work very well is communication amongst and between members of that society. So if you are not able to communicate that vision that you have, you are not able to talk to those around you. It is either that they are not able to recognize what you are saying or what you did represent, or you yourself, you are not also able to indeed take charge of your environment. So in which case, as a youth, you must break that wall of not being able to communicate. When you have to ask questions, ask. Even if people accuse you of asking too many questions, when you ask too many questions, you are not likely going to get to miss your way. So you must communicate at all times. And of course, you must be very, very optimistic. In the Bible, they say, if your faith, no matter how little your faith is, you can move mountains, even if it's as little as the mustard, the smallest. What does that mean? You must be convinced and be optimistic that this thing I want to do is workable. And when you keep at it, you will realize that indeed it's workable. So if you are not optimistic, that you don't believe that this thing can give you results, you will end up not even believing in yourself and yet you expect others to believe in you. So you want to be optimistic as a youth. Of course, the power to motivate and empower. You should be able to motivate yourself, motivate your groups if you are in a group, that be able to give them, though if you are pushing some troubles over time, so don't worry, in a little while we'll get it done. Don't worry, in a little while we'll get it done. And then you begin to see that hope keep you going. And at the end of the day, it empowers other members of the group, or even you, the regenerates and inner strength. You must also be very much willing to accept the feedback. In which case, when people tell you, do you think this thing can be done this way? Why not this? Why not look at that? You take a second look to know whether you need indeed to have this to change your course, or whether to rectify what you're doing, or whether to add more value. Don't just believe that you know it all. That feedback mechanism. Imagine if you are a tailor like the one that sold the one that presented the world in you. If somebody didn't tell you that, look, tailor, this is not how to sew a trouser. It looks like a trouser. It looks more like a job with a carpenter. You will end up sewing that same trouser, and next time nobody will buy it for you. So, but if you look and you take that trip back, possibly you'll be able to make a better trailer that another governor will buy and will not look like the one the president used anymore. Then of course, leading by example. You can't say you have a vision, you have a direction, and you just sit back and you want others to be the one doing it. Let people know that it's doable. What example are you putting forward for those who are in your circle, even if it's your children, even if it's your family members? So as a youth, if you have that vision and you are convinced and you can communicate that vision, and at the same time you can empower those who are working with you yourself to make a difference, and at the same time you can take feedback, you must also be ready to lead by example. Because when you lead by example, even others will believe in you, rather than say, no, go and do it, and you are not able to inspire those. How do you want somebody to lead when he's not the owner of the vision? He will lead wrongly because after the vision, he may not even understand the ingredients that makes us that vision. And that's the one reason why he must also be very willing to lead by example. Be a 360-degree leader. Don't just say, oh, until I become the president or until I become the commissioner. In the little corner where you find yourself, if you are a CLO of an NYSC group, how are you leading members of the group? If you don't provide that leadership, and you think that after all you are not the one who is the director of NYSC, you'll be wasting your time. Even in your family where you have to share things between you and your siblings, provide leadership. Once you do that, you are indeed overcoming that belief that you are immature. Then take responsibility, whether you are below or whether you are up. If something doesn't work well and you know you are not beginning to look for who to blame, when you take responsibility, it gives you the opportunity to begin to think of how to correct it. Because nobody will tell you that you will not make a mistake along the line. Even if you want to become leaders of today and then fast forward the hand of the clock so that you don't have to get it tomorrow, you must be willing to accept that feedback that tells you that you have progressed in error, and then you think of how to make amends with a view to indeed ending well. You also power to drive change, which means you don't have to just say it must be the old way, that's how we used to do it. When you look at the issue of vehicles and brands, and you look back to the 60s, the different brands you're seeing, even when Mercedes, the name remains Mercedes, the C-Class, E-Class, and the beginning GLD, all those things change. People are driving change, and the more change you drive, the more positive you turn out, the more innovative you become, the more difference you're able to make in your society. So even as an inventor or somebody who wants to go into business, you must be ready to drive change, try something new. And that is what some elders are missing. Youth have the ability to try something new, because elders oftentimes believe that that is the cause of things that it must remain the same. And when it remains the same, then no change will happen. After all, it is said that change is the only thing that is constant. So be ready to always make some change and drive it very, very carefully. In the midst of all these, cultivate patience. Don't just say that because you tried it today, it didn't work, then tomorrow you must begin another one. That patience enables you to first of all understand those around you, those who also want to contribute, and then those who are willing to help you grow. If you are not patient and you are looking at just the money you are going to make today, you may end up missing the billions of tomorrow because of the thousands of today. So you must understand that patience is needed in all you do as youth. That you want tomorrow to come today does not mean that you just go and crop it. You must take steps, have the patience, and bring tomorrow back to today so that indeed you become leaders of today. And there's no one leadership style. Don't be dogmatic and think that yes, must go this way. In the course of your leadership, just look at what other people are doing. How were they able to achieve it? Is it in groups? Do they have some common circles? Are they leading alone? Do they have a linear approach or a logistical approach? Once you do all that and you complete it, you will indeed bring your tomorrow to today. Now, having said that, what is the government of Delta State doing to help you bring back tomorrow today? We have tried as much as possible to help you conquer the those challenges I mentioned have been issued. The issues of unemployment, the issues of poverty, the issues of having to have sound education, and many of sorts. You do know that we have a whole lot of empowerment programs targeted at the youth. Because we believe that the youth, for quite some time now, are not financially enabled. And that if we begin to say, because we are government, let us open the government's covers and begin to throw up unemployment letters to people to come into the service, they will end up becoming people who just come to gossip because there are no vacancies that exist in such areas. And what did we do? we decided to invest in value creation. We trade persons, get their data packs, and I can tell you that in the last 6 years, we have trained over 10,000 deltas. And these over 10,000 deltas have remotely empowered no fewer than 100,000 persons. You may want to ask, how did we get to know? We monitor them. There are those, even one person, who have trained no fewer than 70 persons, just one person. I'm happy that my very good sister is here, the speaker fellow, who talked about certification. That certificate that she's talking about, she has also been able, through her programs, empowered, of course, through impartation of skills, a number of mentors who in turn have also engaged others that today are entrepreneurs in their own right. Why are we doing that? Because we believe that once the youth are enabled, they are emboldened to be able to take charge of their tomorrow today. After time, we discovered that the feminine gender are not having enough. We decided to create a different vehicle for them, targeted solely at girls between the age of 18 and 30. And we call it Girl Child Empowerment Scheme Training Program. Yes. And that one, we are upscaling the number. The last one, we had 900 about 8 months ago that we were engaged. And the government has promised that in the next cycle, we are going to get it as much as 1,350. Initially, it started with 450. That's interpreted this to the other platforms that we have where girls are also involved. We decided to have this specific one because we believe that the society, being quite patriarchal and a little chauvinistic, may be tending towards having been more in the circle of empowerment. And because we do have a whole lot of talented girls, we have now, as a government, initiated a program targeted at getting them to do something different. Beyond that, we have also, in terms of our empowerment and in terms of appointment, brought on board the whole lot of youth. The commissioner for youth is not just the youth, it's a youth who has youth elements in his spirit, and a whole lot of others in that sector. The youngest commissioner that we have today, the commissioner for justice, and the attorney general for the state and the commissioner for justice, is a very young person in the 30 brackets. And so, when you see those, it's aimed at bringing government closer to the people. But we must be ready and willing to let those who are already very much on top to understand that you are very mature, you are very sensible, and you are quite sensitive even without being clergy. That way, you would have ended up bringing your tomorrow to today. Otherwise, if you are not able to show that maturity and you continue to engage in drug abuse, or you continue to use the social media for the purpose of just smiling and gossiping about one individual who may have engaged in what every other person is doing, the only thing that maybe has to feel it, you would have ended up wasting the whole day, a week, a month, and possibly years. When, let me, I am sure most of us here are mature. When I saw the Tiwa Savage video, I told somebody I'm not interested. He said, why? I said, is it because this one is exposed? Many persons, it's just that we get too hypocritical. Many persons are doing worse than that. Why do we make it look as if heaven will fall? And people are sharing it, using their data to check it and then distributing it. The telecommunication companies are making money, and you think that you are doing something. That is not what you should be doing with your social media. Use your social media to look at what inventions are happening elsewhere, and not to begin to gossip whether there is one bubble or whether there is one to communicate. Leave those ones, let them live their life, and you live your life so that you remain focused. Otherwise, if you don't have a destination, every other bus stop will look at like where you are going to. Please have a destination. Thank you.